a fun perspective for me, having to actually raise the microphone. I never get to do that. I'm fortunate to serve as the Civil Rights Director for the Council on American Islamic Relations Oklahoma Chapter. My colleagues from that organization are here this morning. Adam Sultani, who is the best boss I'll ever work for, and Anna Fauci, who is the best coworker anyone could ever wish for. You should all be so lucky to have Anna at your planning committee or serving on your boardroom, serving at your boardroom table. I'm also fortunate to be joined today by my family, who've supported me since day one. It's really their fault that I'm here, so you can thank them for that. I'd be remiss if I didn't take a second to acknowledge the many coalition and community partners that enable the work of CAIR-Oklahoma. My colleagues from the Community Alliance of Oklahoma, the Stand Against Racism Committee, the Sarai Ann Foundation of Oklahoma City, who have provided mentorship and support to the mission of CAIR-Oklahoma and to my growth as a professional. I'm so grateful for all of you. And I also want to take a moment to acknowledge that the struggle for human rights in our state is still very much an ongoing one. And while rights of one individual or one group are threatened here in our state, in our community, none of our rights are secure. So there is a verse from the Quran that my Muslim friends have continually taught me, and it is that whoever threatens or harms an innocent life, it's as though they've harmed all of humanity. But whoever saves an innocent life, it's as though they have saved all of humanity. I like to extend that thought to remind myself that while the rights of one person are under threat, none of the rights of anyone else are safe. But whoever protects and safeguards the rights of one individual, it's as though they have saved the rights of all humanity. Let us all go out today and save the rights of humanity.